Following on from my series, How to Recognize Political Correctness, it would seem that certain YouTube atheists are more than willing to attack Christian superstitious beliefs, but would rather lose a body part, it would seem, than give the same treatment, fairly and equally, to Islamic superstitious beliefs.
This is likely because of Rule 1 of No Faith No Pain's Guide to the PC Narrative, that you must defend minorities at all costs. Islam is a minority religion in the West, although the term minority is debatable for the world as a whole.
Possibly it is the simpler case that they are afraid to criticize Islamic nonsense because you end up getting death threats. Well, this is completely understandable, but you should say so. Are we being disingenuous to notice how much of an easy ride Scientology gets from the same people?
Many PC atheists are terrified of being branded Islamophobic, an irrational fear of Islam. It is not irrational to fear something that really can kill you, but what the PC are really avoiding is an irrational fear and a demonization of Muslim people. That is totally different.
There is no need to fear or hate Muslim people.
We understand the need for cultural integration. We understand that we do not want the streets of Europe to become a battleground. Stop panicking. We don't want any final solution or concentration camps.
However, the best way to achieve cultural integration is not to expect the majority to start pretending they believe these outdated superstitions.
We should not give respect to a belief that is complete and obvious nonsense to anybody who is not brainwashed with that belief from birth.
The best way to achieve integration and peace is to enable people who are Islamic to experience something that up till now they have been completely protected from.
That is, criticism of their beliefs.
Being exposed to logical argument as to why their religion is nonsense is the greatest gift we secularists can give young Muslims. Free thinking has to be kick-started, and it is our duty to do it.
Freedom from religion is freedom from oppression. There is no need to fear Islam any more than there is need to fear Christianity. Logical thought is the death of scripture.
We are not scared to treat Islam and Christianity equally,